So if we now add this tiny little droplet to this smoosh in this tube over here, I will go to gym.
So we're in a GMO lab right now, and this is our glow-in-the-dark beer. It's completely against the Reinheitsgebot.
Hi, and welcome back in the Open Wet Lab in Amsterdam. I'm still doing this YouTube video series on do-it-yourself bio and European policy making. And in this video, I'm going to show you how the regulations of the European Union are actually limiting what you are allowed to do as a do-it-yourself biologist. And as a case study, I'm using the kit that I ordered online from the Odin.
It's called the Do-It-Yourself Bacterial Gene Engineering CRISPR Kit. And it allows anyone to do genetic engineering at home.
And let's see what's in there. Of course, to do genetic engineering, you need a pipette. Petri dishes, pipette tips, bottle, I guess that's boiling some stuff. Agar medium, gloves, small tubes, spreaders and inoculation loops. And the good stuff, store in freezer at minus 20. All right, let's get to it.
This article appeared in the news about Germany that's threatening biohackers with prison.
Now let me show you what this is all about, this whole discussion, like in practice. Well, really, it's about this. You have to prepare some bacteria by heating them up with a transformation mix. By doing that, the bacteria are able to absorb DNA. Next, from this tube from the kit, which has a bacterial plasmid, you take a tiny droplet with a pipette, and it's already in here. And if I would now add this droplet to this tube and actually make these two droplets meet, that is actually considered genetic engineering. And if I do that without a permit, I would go to jail. Now, since this whole discussion started in Germany, I've asked a number of German biohackers for their opinion, and I connected to them through Skype right now from Heidelberg. How are you doing? You know, you are making this vlog series about European policy and do-it-yourself bio. And in each video I'm trying to touch upon a different subject. In the upcoming video I want to go into the regulations around genetic modifications. And that is a hot topic at the moment. You've probably seen the article about Germany threatening biohackers with jail.
Unfortunately, yes.
Yeah. I was wondering, what is your opinion about that?
I have to say, it's one step toward clarification. At least they don't leave us in this gray area, like, can we do it, can we not do it? Mm-hmm. On the other hand, there is another technical report from the previous year where they claim that the CRISPR modification on plants does not constitute genetic modification and so does not fall under the gene technology law, which is the one that regulates GMOs.
Yeah. That's really weird, right? So
yeah.
It kind of depends on the context in which you're using the technology, whether you're allowed to do it or not.
Yes.
So now, of course, I don't want to go to jail. So in order to do this experiment and actually be able and allowed to add DNA to cells and genetically modify them, I made an appointment at a laboratory at a university.
The experiment that I prepared is transforming yeast with GFP. So the yeast becomes fluorescent. And as you may know, with yeast you can make beer. Just not to waste your time, I will skip all the steps and all the procedures and will take you straight to the final result. So, and this is our glow-in-the-dark beer. It's completely against the Reinheitsgebot.
So I'm back in my own lab again, here in the Open Wet Lab in Amsterdam. We are technically able to do exactly what we did in the lab at the university. But the difference is that we are not allowed to do it. And that is because of European regulations.
Even to do basic microbiology, you need to comply with so many requirements that it's basically very, very difficult to do it.
Just as an example, if you would grow a fungi in your fridge, for example, that would be illegal, actually.
A lot of criminals in your country then. Yeah.
What we've learned from the German biohackers is that they have a lot more on their mind and to deal with than just genetic engineering. Because even the simplest microbiology experiments are already regulated by a lot of laws and regulations in their country, while at the same time these experiments are considered safe and completely harmless. The benefits of allowing such experiments are also clear. You would increase the public understanding of science, make room for more innovation, and also you would have happier biohackers. I think there are a lot more European Union-wide issues that need to be addressed in a policy paper that we're writing. With a group of researchers, we're getting together via video connection.
You're not recording now.
I am, yeah, but I'll cut the first part out. To discuss what type of issues that we have found, the partners involved at the moment are the Kapelica Gallery in Slovenia, and UPD in Paris, and also the European Citizen Science Association in Berlin, and also the University of Geneva. Together we're mapping all the European policy issues that affect the do-it-yourself bio movement.